How are you?
Good. Gotta get one last look at it.
Yeah, yeah.
I didn't see any no trespassing signs.
I didn't see one either. I figured, you know, I'm gonna be respectful and, you know,
yeah,
stay out of it. But, you know,
I think here I'll go in it.
Yeah, I wonder if it's been some time.
I figure I'll go in it. I mean, it says thieves will be prosecuted, but it's, yeah, you know, and illegal parking, so I just parked outside.
Oh, yeah. Oh, that's true. Yeah, I parked out in the lot over there.
Yeah, so did I park across the street. Oh, and here's someone who parked inside.
Oh, yeah, all this free parking. Why not? Did you used to work here?
No.
Yeah, I'm just a
I just like the building.
Yeah, I'm a big fan of, like, mid-century architecture. Okay. And mid-century modern.
And this is really quite an unusual building.
It's really fascinating. It's like very, yeah, the modular design and the courtyards. I've actually met a woman, Jan, who used to work here.
Okay.
And when she saw the video, we talked for a long time. And, yeah, we saw the lives and the livelihoods and that took place here and all the memories.
Oh, yeah, yeah. And that's why I always think of when I go into places, you know, lives, you know. And sometimes you wonder, what's it all for, you know what I mean?
Yeah, but the untold human stories, and I think there was a meeting of former employees in the other lot.
Yeah, I saw over here in the lot,
That was like former employees,
you know,
meet up. But the design of it, I'm actually from North Carolina. There used to be, I don't know if you're familiar with Paul Rudolph. He's one of my favorite architects.
No, I'm not.
He did the Burroughs Welcome Center in Research Triangle Park, but it was a similar, really just imaginative office complex. Something like
I know, you know, and you think how many homeless people there are and how much space there is here.
Oh, yeah,
you know.
Or a bunch of, like, millennials and stuff that need apartments.
Yes. Offices, anything. You know,
yeah.
There's so much stuff. Nonprofits.
I was talking to Jan, I was like, some imagination. Imagine if each module is like a different neighborhood, you know, and the courtyards could have little playgrounds in them.
Yeah.
Or something.
Yeah, they could. They could have, like, families, you know, millennials, seniors, whatever.
Yeah.
Yeah. A little shopping or something.
Great community. Communal cafeteria area. And the landscaping, the trees are, you know, they installed and through the bridge, too. I heard they, like, had full-grown trees brought down by helicopter.
Oh, really?
For the courtyards. Yeah,
back when Kmart, now I do remember shopping at Kmart. I remember old enough to remember that, the blue light specials.
I definitely shopped there, like the Kmart Cafe, and I love the video game section, like when with the Game Boys. And,
okay.
Like, yeah. Like,
and yeah, they used to be just a huge retailer, and to see them.
The largest retailer in the world.
Okay.
Yeah.
I didn't know they were the largest. I thought they were like number two or
back
something.
Back in like 1990, it was the largest.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. They were probably getting our picture taken by that lady over there.
Oh, yeah. Well, and then, like,
Zoom One's America's Most Wanted.
Yeah. I'm sure, yeah, America has a few more problems than just some Kmart fans looking at the building.
I don't know what's down the stairway.
I peeked down that one. It was just some plants. But even just the angles of the concrete.
Yeah.
And, like, the intersections of, like, the railings. Look how thick and strong.
Wow.
Yeah,
that is.
This is incredible.
Yeah.
We don't make anything like this anymore.
Oh, man, the scrap value of the steel, you know.
They start making these, like, boxes, like, kind of like, you know, goodbye packages.
Oh.
Just like, once they start seeing, like, half boxes, you make, like, everyone in the office knew it's kind of.
Yeah, the time is, the writing's on the wall.
But yeah, she said, like, the cafeteria was amazing. You'd get omelets, everything was made fresh. And just the, you know.
Almost like a tech company or something.
Yeah, it sounds like, Google before Google or something. Yeah, like.
Well, I know they did have the data warehouse. Well, it was the headquarters, so they did have their data center here. And they would receive the internet wasn't around then. So
that's what she worked for the data center. She would convert the magnetic reels to, like, so they could into searchable databases. And she said, like, they had the first satellite dish.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say, is that they got all the information from the stores from satellites.
And I don't know if you looked at a map, that little building that's on the edge over there in the parking lot. There's this little building. I was like, what is that, like a security station or something? She said that's where the satellite was. That was like the satellite
and
building.
Probably electronics. And
probably, a whole, like, server room
in
there.
Which back then was probably huge.
I didn't even need to heat it.
Now you can get it.
I'm very curious, but at the same time, I've got an answer on that. I've looked at buildings before, and some, you know, sometimes security comes off. I mean, it seems pretty lax, but I don't know.
I know it's open right over there.
Yeah, I saw that. I heard some sounds inside. It sounded like someone was, you know, like some power tools. Someone might be salvaging something.
Oh, wow, okay.
So, yeah, I'm curious, obviously, but I'm happy being outside.
And, you know,
and there's pictures.
I've been inside buildings, too, and it's like, it's not that great, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's just a bunch of old stuff, you know.
It's exciting, but, I really just wanted to see it. I saw the article in the Free Press.
I think that's why everyone's here. I mean, I saw the cars parked across the street. I'm wondering how many people are inside. They're probably having a party or something.
Yeah.
They're having a party over here, you know. So, but yeah, as soon as I drove by, I saw the thing. It didn't say no trespassing, just illegal parking. So I pulled in, and then I saw you sitting here taking pictures. I'm like, well,
I figured the same.
I'm not doing anything.
You know, if someone asks me to leave, I'll leave.
Yeah,
but,
exactly.
Yeah.
And I'll just say, reminiscing.
Yeah.
You know?
Do you remember the days of Kmart? people are nostalgic about it.
Yeah.
And just the architecture also, what this really was, too. The iridescent glass is huge. Like, there's lots that you can see that on some of the other buildings around here. You just don't see them.
And so much is what you're talking about. I saw the original Star Wars. Saw it on TV. I haven't kept up with it at all. None of the other sequels or anything. But they had the original on TV. And I was surprised how cheesy it was. You know, when I was 11, especially back then, where there weren't as many special effects. They didn't have all the computer generated stuff.
But that's not, I like the practical effects are better. Like, the Star Destroyer has real shadows on it.
Yeah.
And, like, I mean, it makes a difference. You know, the TIE Fighter actually exploded.
Being older and stuff and seeing all the effects were more jaded, and I'm looking at it, and actually some of it looked really cheesy now. Before, the first time I saw it, I was like, wow, everything is so cool.
I'd rather have an alien, someone in an alien costume than a computer generated.
Yes,
Like with actual fur, the banthas and stuff.
And it does still hold up.
Yeah.
But it's just a little more jaded now. Some of the parts of it.
They're trying so much stuff, not all of it sticks.
Yeah.
It's like the movie, my favorite movie is Alien, and that's an incredible movie, but the scene, the cyborg scene where they, the name of the cyborg guy, he gets like decapitated, and it's got like all that white blood and tubes and stuff, and it looks a little B-movie. But then other parts of the movie are like, just like, I can't believe like that xenomorph, so it looks totally real and it's trippy.
But
I
like
to
see
Yeah. Good. It always made me fall asleep with that jazz music. But Alien's cool. That holds up really well. That's just an incredible movie. First of its kind, the whole sci-fi horror.
Yeah. Well, I think I'm going to look down here a little bit.
Doesn't seem like anyone cares.
I'm
going to walk around a little bit. What's your name?
Joel.
Joel, my name's Miles.
Miles?
Yeah.
Nice to meet you.
Nice meeting you.
Was that your tripod over there?
Yeah.
Okay.
I just went handheld.
All right.
Yeah. I'll go back for it. I don't think anyone's going to take it.
I was thinking about it.
It's from a thrift store. It's nothing fancy.